So what we're going to do is we are going to invert that so it looks like. Today I want to show you how to create a 3D room in Construct 3. Yeah, so let me open a Construct 3. Let me show you the example. Here is the example file. You can see that it's some sort of fake 3D room. I'm gonna go to Live Photoshop. And you can see that I have a few versions. Let me try this one with this very creepy lady. I'll save this as a PNG file. Bring it to Construct. And let me just import this. Let's run this. Oh, okay, we have to. I forgot to. Now these images, you have to flip them upside down. Don't ask me why. That's how the lens works. There we go. Let me import that again. Here we go. There is our super creepy lady. Let me try another one. I actually got one from Fnaf Candy here. Not sure, I got it from the internet. And it works the same way too. You can make a fake 3D room. Okay, so let me show you how I did this. Okay, so let's alright, so I'm gonna go file new. New project. Call it Super Project. Or Super 3D Room. And I'm going to make this a landscape. Let's make this a 1600 by 480. There's our project. I'm going to go to view and let me set this to outer, scale outer. There we go. Let's import our picture. Tile background. And I'm going to use this here. That Fnaf picture. Let me snap to grid. Now I wasn't going to make this a tutorial, but I think it's fun. Let's see, I think that ends there. Let me actually make that 1600 by 480. There we go. Run this. Let me set this to letterbox scale. And I think that works better. Okay. So, let me just lock that background. And let's insert another object. This is going to be my main object. Paint it. Make it smaller. Actually, I'm going to make it a bar. There we go. And let's make this an 8 direction object. Set the speed to maybe 600. Acceleration to 2000. And deacceleration to 2000 as well. Only two directions, left and right. There we go. Actually, I think that viewport should be smaller. Let me see. Viewport size should be 800 only. Okay, that works better. Let me insert two objects here so we can leave the play area. Let's make them yellow. You don't have to. You can make them whatever color you want. You can make it rainbow color if you wanted to. Let me add a behavior to this. Make it solid. So if you run into this, you can go through it. You don't even have to program anything. I'm going to copy this. And let's place another copy on the other side. We can't scroll yet. Let's go to the event sheet. And if the timer is greater than 0, which is all the time, then we can scroll to that object. There we go. So now we can scroll. Just like that. Let me make those objects invisible at start. Initially invisible. Invisible. Make the red bar invisible as well. Maybe we should save this. And so let's run this. So now we just have the scrolling. Okay, make this a little bigger. So now we can add the fake 3D effect. So all you have to do is click on the layer, and then you can add a an effect. Add effect. I'm going to add a sphere. And you can see that this works right away. There is that sphere effect. So what we're going to do is we are going to invert that so it looks like, let's invert it, set the radius to 60 and set the reflective index to -30. There we go. You can see that it's almost like we're inside the bubble instead. Try it out. And that's it. I wish there was more to it, but unfortunately, that's all there is to it. You can change the images, like I showed you at the beginning of the video. In the next video, I'll show you how to do the scrolling using your mouse. To drop a like down below and leave a comment. Say anything. If you guys do gaming, don't forget to check out the SparkTube, okay? Upload your gaming videos there. Alright guys, see you in the next video. Bye now.
Listen, Molten. We should have left when we had the chance. Yeah, I know. I know. Subscribe to what? What channel? What do you mean, like the video and subscribe? Now, Molten, you have really lost it. I should just kick you out there in the ocean. Thank you.